Layer properties and storyline are a lot like slide properties in that when revisiting, you can automatically decide, reset to initial state, or resume the save state of the layer. Automatically decide is the default. These work almost identically to slide layer properties. So here I have a group, you click it, it shows the automatically decide layer. When you click this one, it shows the reset to initial state layer. Let's take a look. So the automatically decide layer shows this, the reset layer shows this, automatically decide, and they work identically. So you may be wondering, what's the difference? Well, just like a slide in Storyline, if you have any interactions or objects with states like selected or visited on a layer, automatically decide will then automatically decide that you have interactions happening, so I'm going to resume the save state. I'm gonna go ahead and format paint that X button over onto the reset layer, and now they both have a selected state. Let's go ahead and preview again to see the difference now. So now I have a selected state on the automatically decide layer. So when I click this button, it's hiding the layer, but I also selected that X button. With automatically decide on layers and slides, Storyline will resume if you have states of selected, visited, things like that, indicating interaction. So that's why automatically decide now is no longer playing the animation. It's just appearing because it's deciding that, hey, there's interaction. I just need to remember where we left off. Now let's go to reset and remember I format painted. So there is a selected state on this X, but even though that state is there, I told the layer to always reset to the initial state. So that means forget everything, just start over. So that's why even though there are states and interactions within this layer, every time I click to show it, it's showing up as a new. And you can make things work exactly the way that you want them now that you can leverage this knowledge. Thanks for your time.